It was stacked.
Exactly.
Pulls,
like. So, like, you know, that's important too.
Yeah. So, right. so it's Bene and Unsinlos and DNL and Kunai KK Zakun. So Kunai obviously is Toon Link, Mega Man, then therefore being DNL.
Yes.
And then if I can find out, it's Bene is Corrin.
Yes.
Bene is Corrin.
And Unsinlos is Unsinlos rather, I believe.
Is a. He actually apparently uses Falco when it comes to singles, but opting for the Roy in doubles and Rob in doubles.
Yeah.
Roy's in my head. Roy, sorry. Okay, so you know we're half a minute into this first game. No stocks taken yet, but you know a nice spread of damage being done across. Very very nice gyro, but does not get the connection.
Not quite. So right now, green team is doing a decent job of controlling the space. But blue team seems to be fighting back and controlling space.
Kunai had lovely vision there. He got the up smash into Lion-O up air, and then immediately turned around to get a grab. Nice up smash there from Mega Man, from DNL, getting that up smash to get the kill on Bene.
That's a fantastic punish move. Mega Man's up smash, double sided. It starts up fast and has great killing power. Mm. It's just it's a fantastic way to close off a stock. Good stuff. On Sinlos trying to keep. He's trying to stay at a distance, use his range and projectiles, really putting Rob's talents to work.
Bene just being a little bit, exactly there. Kunai, very, very good team's mentality to knock away and immediately focus your attention elsewhere.
Yes.
Even if you're in the one-on-one scenario and you're winning, you don't have to push it, you can change.
Speaking of push it, Unsinlos got it pushed out of the stage with like the coveted Mega Man kill, the double up air, double jump up air. And you just get pushed right off the top.
Yeah.
So he loses his first stock there. Second to lose a stock. Right now, green team is falling behind. Green team is falling behind. Blue team hasn't lost a stock yet. Wow, Kunai at 170, DNL at 146. These guys do not want to die right now. Holding it down so, so well. Here goes Unsinlos trying to keep DNL out. They just can't seem to place a good kill confirm. There it goes. Bene is, I believe that's how you put on Bene.
I was saying Bene.
Bene.
But I think that's just me trying to be silly. It could. it may just be as simple as Bene. There's the Nair coming up. Finally taking Mega Man's first stock.
Yes, but at what expense? Because they spent so much of their percent making that happen, and now you know they're onto their. Reaching their last stocks now.
Yeah, I mean, they're just having to be a little bit more cautious in their recoveries. You know, the jump option is so obvious, and it's very easy for, you know, Toon Link to cover those and punish those. Get the spike on there, but a tech did keep Rob a little bit safe.
Yeah. Kunai just landed so much damage on Unsinlos.
I feel like Bene's, I was mentioning earlier, being overextending a little bit, you know, being a little bit too aggressive and not focusing on his defense too much here and there, getting punished for it.
Yeah, I would have to agree with that. It's causing, costing him a lot of damage. And here's the tough part about fighting blue team is that they're both using characters who have projectiles that come in at such, you know, dangerous intervals and control so much space. So it's a lot for a character like Corrin to handle because there's always something. There's either a bus saw coming from the front or a bomb coming from behind. It's hard to watch your
nice
back.
Nice stage spike.
Nice.
Indeed, yeah. And the thing is, like, the amount of strength they have and what you can do with those.
Look at that. Being tossed into the bomb. Like,
oh, that was nice. I think they were trying a little bit over-eager to get something very, very stylish there. But all they have to do is just finish it off.
Yeah. I guess they feel pretty confident considering Unsinlos's percent and the fact that they have 3 stocks to 1. So they probably, you know, we had a bit of breathing room to try to style on our opponent. Little cute footstool, another footstool from Kunai. They're just gonna close it off. No more grabs, no more footstools. Just finish off that round. So amazing job to blue team there.
I definitely felt the blue team. Obviously, we're talking about their projectile usage and you know how much kind of pressure it can exert with those. Making much better use of that as well. I didn't see too many lasers from Rob. I mean, it's very, you know, when you've got such a linear stage like that, a very flat stage, it's kind of hard to get those in place and kind of make them work well when it is such an all-covering kind of, move.
Yeah.
Bombs, all those kind of things from Toon Link. They're very, like, single target, really, you know. It's a small thing. It doesn't cover up a huge amount of space. I mean, we didn't really see too much of the Dragon Fang shot either.
Well, here's the thing about the Rob's laser. You could go one of two ways about it. Either you constantly wait to charge it up so that you have that burst option every once in a while, or you don't let it get to that point because you want that, you know, quote unquote full screen jab. You want to keep using the weakest part just so you have like spatial control. And yeah. I think in teams, that's probably more of an effective thing to control space, is just to use the weak part of it. Because if you see your partner from the other side getting bothered by the opponents, you can just toss that weak laser and be like, no, yeah, stop that.
It's more disruption than anything else, isn't
it? Yeah, exactly. So maybe I want to see a little bit more of just rapid fire or laser movement, laser usage from Ancelos.
Very, very nice from DNL to cover Kunai there after getting the down throw. The up air could not confirm in that regard.
And DNL just rocking the sleeve shield so often. It just bothers the opponent so much. It doesn't let them really do what they want to do.
Ooh. DNL going for the hard knuckle, but not landing. I just think that what Green Team need to do is just, they need to kind of deal with the walls that are being set up a little bit better. And I think, you know, a little bit, oh, very nice grab, yeah. The down air, very bad timing there, unfortunately, from Benet. From Benet. Gets caught out.
All right. Kunai trying his way back. That's the beauty about Toon Link. You have that chain link, and you can just tether characters, have such, ooh. Oh wow, ding them in the head. Let's see if you can, Benny just kind of respects the recovery. Doesn't really want to touch it, get clipped. So he just held shield there.
Benny not bringing his shield up quite a lot. Just took some lemons, and it's just 3%, isn't it? You know, you want to try and deny that as much as possible.
Oh,
there's a Dragon Fang shot.
Doesn't find a mark there, though. Nice. You know, inside B. Benny jumping off, just getting tagged left and right from everybody, racking up a significant amount of percent. Still continues to get hit by everybody. Benny is just, it's like he's fighting a free-for-all here.
DNL finally losing that stock as well. He is the tankier of the two characters as Toon Link goes as well, but kind of similar situation to last time. The percentage is not looking good for Green Team at this current point. A nice setup would be, you know, bad for the Green Team.
Yeah, that wouldn't work. Although I do have to commend Kunai. So far, he's been the one to kind of take damage last. He's always the one at like 150, 160 in this set. And I do have to commend him for that, because that's the kind of role I feel like you have to fill with Toon Link. You're very small, nimble, and you have projectiles to protect yourself. You should be stock tanking. You shouldn't be really getting hit too much.
Benet has no defense, no shield. I just need to hold the R, hold the R button, dude. Come on.
You do have buttons on the side. You got to put it to use, because he's just trying to swipe away the lemons. Like, this isn't Fruit Ninja. You're playing Smash right now, man. You can't swipe away those lemons. He's just going to get tagged.
I do understand the frustration, though. It's one of those things you're just like, just let me get a hit.
Like, it is annoying to just, you know, like, it's like you're getting lightly smacked in the face. Like, what are you going to do about it, huh? You're going to hit me, huh? Like, what are you going to do?
But it is percentage, you know? It may be one or two over the course of three or four lemons, but it is percentage.
It all adds up. Whiff grab there from DNL. DNL really fishing for the grab. He wants to start something cool. He tried to go for the footstool. Benny swinging away.
Almost toying with their food right now, but Benny just needs to find a little bit of composure just to try and show that he's got some kind of, just, you know, show that fight that's still in him.
Oh, that bomb finds his way through, sending Benny off his feet. Not quite going to kill just yet. That recovery is pretty good, though. Oh, the Tron.
Went low,
the
counter!
Almost took both of them out.
That would have been so sick if he got it.
Oh, my God. But he still has a multitude of damage to deal before he finds his way out of this mess. And at 170, it's not mean to say that it's highly unlikely. Yeah. No.
There it goes. That's a clean 2-0 over to Kunai.
Yes. Very, very nice
and
play.
And DNL.
I was very impressed with Kunai's play, how he was able to just keep himself from taking too much damage, and all the meanwhile laying damage with his projectiles. It's very easy to get lost in the mayhem of teams and just find yourself bouncing around. That was happening to Benny. He was getting hit by both opponents on the team, and his teammate would just find his way to just hit him, and it was just unfortunate.
I think it was, sometimes it's like, I mean,